think it's really important for everyone to be able to experience life to the fullest. And if giving a guide dog to someone and helping Guide Dogs Queensland achieve that, then that's enough for me. I've been watching
you for so long. Starts at home for me because I've got two broods. So what I need to do is feed them, walk them, I usually groom them, and then I come into work here and I go straight into the breeding centre. So I'll go in and socialise the pups. I will also take them out and play with different toys. So we want toys that are noisy, we want toys that have got flashing lights, we want toys that move. So the pups, while they're in a safe environment, get exposed to so many different sounds, sights and movements. So when they do go out into the world and with puppy raises, then they, if they see something different, because they've been exposed to so many things in the safe environment in the breeding centre, they're not fazed by anything outside.
You receive the puppy from Guide Dogs Queensland when they're about 8 to 10 weeks old. My job is to get it ready for certain formal training, which is done by the professional trainers back at Guide Dogs Queensland after the dog is about 18 months old. And they teach the dog more specific things. I love dogs. I love seeing the change in them as they grow from being this tiny bundle of fluff when you receive them at 8 weeks old to when you hand them over at 18 months into formal training. And it's a sense of achievement for me. But again, it's also for that bigger picture that I'm helping someone else.
Jack, my son, is 12 years old now. He was diagnosed with Leber's congenital amaurosis, which means he doesn't have enough light receptors on his retinas. We went home and were devastated. I guess because it's always, it's every question you ask, and it would be the same for every disability, but how's he going to cope? What's he going to do? Is he going to have a job? Is he going to get married? Is he going to have kids? Is he going to be able to live independently? All that stuff. Having a guide dog just opens up their world. I think they're just so much more mobile with a guide dog.
The cost of raising and training a guide dog to be ready to be a working dog is about $40,000 to $50,000 for each dog. Now, I can't give that sort of money. But I can give my time and I can give my patience and I can give my love to get the dog to the stage where it can be trained and fulfill that guiding role for someone who really needs it.
I lost my sight when I was 10 and I worked with orientation and mobility first with a long cane with guide dogs, and then when I was around 18 I then was able to graduate to getting a guide dog, and he's been excellent though because I've been working here, so he's been helping me get to work every day, of course going out, socialising. Yeah, he's definitely a unique personality as well. Having a guide dog, it was definitely made me a lot more independent.
I've included Guide Dog Queensland in my will. If friends and family got whatever money I had, they might take a holiday, buy a car, but by giving that money to Guide Dog Queensland, I know that somebody or multiple people will have freedom and independence.
Vision's probably one of the worst senses to lose because you never get a full picture of everything, you know. Like, I guess for me it's just I want for him to be independent like everybody else is. And to me, you know, Guide Dog's going to be one of those ways for him to do it. So that's what I want for him. Yeah.